One question that's bothered us and many people for many years is what really is an appropriate control group for comparing active treatment. Is usual care, the conventional treatments that people get from their primary care clinician typically, is that an appropriate comparison? Does sham acupuncture itself actually have some physiologic effects that might be more than simply placebo? Can we blind the therapist? I'd argue for most of these physical treatments, we can't blind the therapist. They know if they're delivering the real thing or not. Perhaps we can blind patients, but I think that's an open question. Most of the studies have not really looked at whether patients were successfully blinded to their therapy or not. And then there's an issue that I think hasn't gotten a lot of attention in interpreting clinical trials, and that is who volunteers for clinical trials. I would argue that the patients who volunteer for a trial of acupuncture, for example, are probably, by and large, people who have a hunch that acupuncture is going to be helpful for them. They probably have positive expectations. They may indeed be disappointed if they're not randomly allocated to the active intervention, but they have favorable expectations, at least. And that really creates a question about the generalizability of the results. If we see a positive result, will that generalize to people who don't have a favorable expectation or really don't think that acupuncture is going to be of any use? And then finally, we're plagued over and over in this field by small effect sizes. We sometimes see very small differences that look statistically significant but maybe not clinically important. And how do we interpret those? The advocates of the CAM therapies would say, here's proof that it works, statistically significant differences. And the detractors would say, well, here's the evidence that it doesn't work. There's no clinically important difference. It's a placebo. And we have that sort of interpretive difference that's going to be hard to resolve, I think, as long as we have these small effect sizes. As a result of those kinds of problems, I think it's actually going to be hard to come to a definitive conclusion about many of the CAM therapies for pain. You can actually find randomized trials that will support any position you want to take. It's actually easy to do that, and various experts have done that. The treatment effects, I think, really are consistently modest, or we'd probably have no controversy about these things. If there were a slam dunk here, we'd probably know it by now. And one of the consequences is that you and I may disagree at the end of this talk even on what the proper interpretation of some of these studies is, and that's probably okay. I think ongoing dialogue about these things is going to be important.